So thanks for making some time. Probably a busy schedule in 5 weeks for you. How are you doing?
Very good. How about you?
I'm doing pretty fine. I'm really excited for UFC Paris. It's always a big event for us in Holland, and we're really excited. Just wondering, how's your preparation been for the last couple of months towards this fight?
I'm excited for the fight too. UFC Paris is going to be a good one, and I have been training a lot. I have been putting the work, especially because it's going to be 5 rounds, so I'm putting some extra rounds and extra effort on the training camp, so I'm feeling ready.
Yeah, that's also because you said 5 rounds. You said before you're hungry for big fights, for opportunities. How important is this fight for you, your UFC career, you think?
I think is a very important, the platform that a main event brings to you, right? So Paris main event, 5 rounds. I'm ready, and I'm feeling great about this.
I was just looking back to it. It's 10 years ago when you joined the UFC, 2014. Is the fire still there? Do you still have the same motivation, or ha has your fighting life changed over the years?
I still have even more motivation, but the motivation is different. I remember 10 years ago when I was doing the walk, when I was making the walk to the cage, and my only motivation was to be a UFC fighter. My whole life, I always wanted to be a UFC fighter. That was my goal, that was my dream. And on that day, 10 years ago, I was fulfilling my dream to be a UFC fighter for the first time. But now, you being a UFC fighter is not enough. I want money. I want to be rich. I want to have a lot of money and success, and be a legend of the sport. So my dreams are even higher right now, but I am doing what I can to fulfill them again.
And it's been a great year for you. I saw you fight live. I was in Las Vegas for UFC 300 against Jalen Turner. That was something special, right?
Yes, that's special. I remember we even doing some stuff on the fight week, right? We did
Yes. Yep. We
some
did
stuff
some
on the fight
interviews
week.
together, some
Yes,
jokes. Yeah.
some jokes, exactly. No, the UFC 300 was great. It was something else, right? I remember like it's today, and I'm very happy to be able to compete at the same card as such a great fighters and legends. And this year is being great so far.
Yeah, because it's going to be a third fight this year. Do you like being so active?
Yes, because usually I never have been so active because I have been dealing with injuries my whole career. But right now I feel healthy, and I feel I am 35. I need to compete, so I'm competing September. And if I can, I will compete in December. If I can, I will do four, five fights this year. I have to take advantage of the time.
I liked it. I like this dedication for the sports. We just were talking about it. That's 10 years for you now in the UFC, but it's going to be the first time you're fighting in Europe.
Yes,
How is
the
that
first time
possible?
being in Europe. I never been to Europe. That was my first
Really? It's your
time.
first time in Europe.
Yeah, first time in Europe. Yeah.
Wow. How
Yeah.
does that feel?
Feel great. Feel great. I was, to be honest with you, from stuff that we hear and read, I thought Paris was bad, but Paris is very nice.
Why do you thought it was bad?
I don't know.
What did he tell you?
People are talking about first, like that was a dirty city with a lot of rats and stuff, like New York, right? Like very crowded and very and a lot of crazy people. I was thinking like a wild place, but I'm not seeing that. I'm seeing I saw some rats and some dirty, but not much, not much. It's a big city, right?
Beautiful buildings, right?
Beautiful buildings, beautiful history. I am very impressed because in Brazil, this is Europe, right? The old continent. So a lot of history.
True.
Yesterday I went to the Louvre and I was
Oh,
watching the
nice.
paint. some of the paints is like from the 1400s. So Brazil was not in the map at the time, and Europe was building castles and painting. So I'm very impressed with everything that I see until today.
Is that something you do more often during fight week, like go to buildings like the Louvre?
Yes, usually I like to walk. I like to take a walk when I, especially when I get a little bit earlier, like I did here. I got here on Saturday, so I had time, and I make time for Saturday and Sunday to walk, to see the place, to talk to some people, to try to understand, because I never know. I never know when I'm getting back to Paris, you know. I never know. So I'm taking advantage of that. And especially because I'm a big fan of history. I love history. So I went to all the places, right? In France that you see and you read in movies and books. So it was a very cool experience to me.
Yeah, you're fighting in a well-known arena, the Accor Arena. I've been there the last two editions of UFC Paris. I think the atmosphere is insane. I was standing last year next to Tom Aspinall, and he said he was fighting in London, but he said Paris, it's a next level. Have you heard something about the atmosphere there?
No, not really. I saw on the TV on the last car, right, on Paris. That was that we could see through the TV that people were very pumped. They are very happy to be over there, and I think it's going to be the same.
Yeah, and especially you're fighting against Benoît Saint-Denis. He is from France. Do you think that his home field advantage is going to be really big? How do you look at that?
Really big. It's going to be huge. It's going to be like the last time, 100%. You know, people are going to be cheering for him. People be supporting him. But as soon as the fight goes, they're going to be more quiet.
I'm not surprised by this answer, but what do you think of Saint-Denis?
I think Saint-Denis is a very good fighter. I think he's aggressive. I think he's a finisher, right? He has like a lot of finishes on his resume, but I like my chances. I'm ready, and it's a fight, you know, it's a fight. Everything can happen bad, but I trust on my training camp, on my coaches and what I did, and I'm ready to beat him on Saturday.
Yeah, of course you saw his last fight against Dustin Poirier. How did you look at that? What did you see? What you can take advantage of?
It's hard, you know, because I could say he gassed out a little bit on the fight because he was putting so much pressure. But Dustin is a great fighter. I train with Dustin. I know he can knock anybody out, you know, on the division. Dustin is a very good fighter. But I don't know. Maybe he training his gas tank a little bit more. Maybe he's going to be more patient. It's very hard to say how he's going to act. And I'm not focused on that. I am focused on my performance and what I need to do, you know. And I'm not telling what I'm doing. But one thing I can do can one thing I can tell for sure, I'm winning this fucking fight.
Okay, so you're not going to tell what your game plan is, but tell me, how do you see the fight playing out?
But if I say that, this is my game plan, right?
Yeah, but okay, which round are you? I assume that in your head, you're confident you're going to finish him. Which round?
I don't know. I hope on the second, on the third, but. If the fight goes to the distance, I don't have a problem with that. I just want the double checks. I want money, you know? I want to win.
So if you win, I'm always so excited for your post-fight speech. Do you have something already made up, what you're going to say?
Yeah, a little bit. Not much. I will improvise, but I have some lines that I'm thinking to talk. But really depends, right? Really depends on the fight. Like Jalen Turner, I got the TKO in the second round, so I was very pumped. So it's going to be the same. If I beat him on the first and the second, that's going to be something. If it's a decision, it's another thing, you know? Will depend because I don't plan. I don't plan. I just react.
Yeah. I'm really looking forward to see you fight this Saturday in Paris. Last question. I think it's a difficult one. Can you give us the Mount Fightmore of Brazil? So your top five Brazilian fighters of all time.
UFC fighters or overall fighters?
UFC.
UFC. Anderson Silva.
Of course.
José Aldo. Anderson Silva, José Aldo. Vitor Belfort. Who else could I say?
Is it too early for Alex?
You believe he's still competing, right? But
Yeah.
he's still competing.
So it's too early for him?
Yeah, I
So
think it's too early. Great of all times. I don't know. But maybe I'm biased, right, through to the old fighters. But Alex
yeah.
probably should be there. Probably Alex should be there. And I would say,
Money Maikano.
no, not yet. I have still, you know, to be in the great of all times, you need to be champion. I'm not champion yet, but maybe someday, maybe someday.
Okay, we'll put you at five, and you still have to deserve the spot for real. But we'll put you in the top five. I want to thank you so much, Renato. Great talking to you, like always. And good luck this Saturday, and hope to see you soon.
Thank you so much, my friend. See you soon.
I appreciate it, Renato. Thank you so much.
Appreciate it. Bye-bye.
Bye.